All right, I have an email here that I'm going to be reading. Printed this out, and I'm going to have to cover up the name and everything else because it's a controversial thing. It's about the San Bernardino area and child ritual abuse, satanic ritual abuse, specifically dealing with law enforcement and the police out there, as well as the schools, and a lot of this stuff works in collusion. This stuff goes on all over the country. The infamous Omaha, Nebraska, the Franklin scandal with Boys Town America, the Roman Catholic orphanage for boys, and it's all over the place. I mean, Pennsylvania, my home state where I'm from, they had the whole Jerry Sandusky thing, Penn State, and all this stuff, and he was molesting boys, and it was being covered up by Joe Paterno, the head coach of the football team, and everything else. All the time, all the time. It's going on all over the place. And it's always the Catholics that are involved in this thing. Okay? But here's the whole thing. It's not just a bunch of pervert priests doing this. This thing is involved with law enforcement and a lot of other things. And these guys are getting away with this thing as far as the prosecution of these people is not happening in the courts. They're getting away with it. We'll be talking about that in this study. I'm also going to be showing you what we as Bible-believing Christians can do about it, all right? Because there's a lot of, people will talk about this thing. They'll talk about some of the satanic ritual abuse, the mind control, the MK Ultra, a lot of the CIA experimentation, but they'll leave you just kind of going, oh man, what do we do? I'm going to talk about solutions today because I've known about this thing for a long time. I have a video way back in 2011. You can look it up. Just type in Jesuit satanic ritual abuse. And I was talking about how the Jesuits are involved in this thing and showing newspaper articles proving that. So, yeah, it's a big issue here in America. Be real careful before you say, God bless America. Okay, but this is a recent thing here. Dear Brother Brian and his lovely wife, thank you for responding to my email so quickly. I am sorry that it has taken so long for me to respond. I'm going to leave out a lot of this stuff because I don't want this woman to be identified. So I'm going to leave out some of the personal details. Okay. Did you hear about the second shooting in San Bernardino, California? This happened just a few weeks ago, back in April. Well, I guess we are still technically in April. Okay. But just back in April, there was a black man that had married this, he had his black wife, and she was working as a teacher at this school out there in San Bernardino, California, and he supposedly walks in and just kills her and I think killed another student and wounded another one, if I remember correctly, and then he kills himself. We'll talk more about that as we continue what's going on with that whole thing, but she's from this area and very familiar with it. Continuing here, it says, it is not a coincidence that there have been two major shootings there at this school. It was also the second city in the U.S. to become bankrupt from the mayor cooking the books. It also has a Mexican and a Venezuelan consulate and is a sanctuary city. A lot of cities here in America, they'll bring in illegal aliens and say, we'll keep you safe here. We won't let law enforcement go after you, which is criminal, really. It really doesn't matter what your opinions on that are, one way or the other. It's criminal. They're illegal aliens. They shouldn't be here. It is also where Dr. William Ross Addy, one of the top experts in ELF technology, extremely low frequency is what ELF stands for mind control, lived for many years. It also has Loma Linda University Medical Center, which is known for human experimentation, especially on co-joined twins. Reminds me of the Nazi doctor that was given the name of Dr. Death. Josef Mengele was the guy's name. Mengele was this. Again, I got to go back here and kind of explain some things. Some of you might know about this, others are going, huh? You go way back. Let's go way, 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 way back. You can go way back to ancient Egypt before Jesus even showed up on the earth, and they were messing around with some of this stuff. But Roman Catholicism, specifically, the Roman Empire that merged into became the Catholic Church around, sometime in the 4th century, essentially. They, for centuries, thousands of years actually, have been torturing people. They are experts in torture, all through the Dark Ages, up through, you know, the Reformation years and things like that. You had the Spanish Inquisition, all these different things. They have been torturing people, and they, I mean, the types of torture is just like extreme creative type of stuff. I mean, I won't even get into all this stuff. I mean, you can read Fox's Book of Martyrs. I have it here somewhere. You can read Fox's Book of Martyrs. You can read The Martyr's Mirror. You can read a lot of this stuff. They were experts in torture. And you say they just were doing that just to horribly kill people and whatever else. Well, that's there. But they were also doing it as experimentation on how to basically warp people's minds. And, you know, and of course this became with the Nazi movement, they were looking for ways to create the ultimate soldier. And this goes into the thing of mind control to the point of, okay, you can fracture somebody's mind and cause amnesia walls because the torture is so bad. You know, it's kind of like if you cut yourself really bad, you might not feel the pain right away because in your mind you're in shock, kind of like, whoa, okay, you're looking down and there's like something really bad happening. And I remember when I cut my thumb real bad years ago, it literally went down into the bone. I severed the tendon right on the top of my thumb. That's why I have a big scar on my thumb, and it doesn't quite go up the whole way anymore because I don't have a tendon up top. And I remember it was like I was holding it, and I was going, I can't believe I did this. And I remember at the time I was at my parents' place, and I said, my dad was like, we got to get you to the hospital. I was like, I'm not going to the hospital. It'll be fine. And I went in to wash it off, and I let go of my thumb, and the two things of skin opened up, and I'm looking in and seeing the bone and the severed tendon, and I was like, oh, wow. I didn't even feel the pain. You know, it was just like, that's really disgusting. And I'm just like, man. And there's just blood like pumping out of the thing. And all of a sudden I started feeling a little bit lightheaded. And I was like, oh, okay. Better to go to the hospital. Ended up getting 7 stitches and whatever. But the whole point is, God designed our brains in a way that if you feel extreme pain or if you feel some kind of traumatic thing, you'll kind of just go, okay, you disassociate from it. And see, Satan and his minions, particularly the Catholic Church, which you'll see in this email here, that they're involved, they understand this thing. And so they've been experimenting with people. The Nazis were doing it very much. That are there ways to cause extreme pain with people to fragment the mind and then get them into an altered state of mind and program that and then find ways to kind of hide that in their personality, and then you can trigger it and make them go out and kill people, and then, you know, program them, you know, in another way. You say other code words and whatever else, and they forget what they did. And, you know, they're really interested in this idea of this concept of this super soldier. So Mengele was very much involved in that. And he had this big thing for, you know, experimenting with people. After the war, he went down to Argentina. And it's like, well, he just kind of fled and he just disappeared, you know. No, in reality, it was Operation Paperclip, where the Nazi scientists, a lot of them were brought to America. Another famous one was John Denver, the folk singer. His real name is Henry John Deutschendorf. His dad was a Nazi scientist. So he's the son of a Nazi scientist that was brought here after the war. And there's a whole bunch of stuff with John Denver, too, being into the New Age and a lot of other things. But these people were brought to America and up into Canada as well. And they were, you know, you had the early, I forget if it was Monarch or MKUltra that happened first. But, you know, they had this whole program. And they've been experimenting on people here. So this goes back to this thing of Mengele, which she mentioned here. The thing of Dr. Death was his nickname that they gave him. And then you had Sidney Gottlieb working for the CIA. I can show you, I have his obituary actually in my files. And they talk about how he was experimenting with, I can't think of the thing, is it lysergic sodium dichlorothide or something? LSD, the drug. That was a CIA drug, nicknamed Acid. And today you have like the Vice News, you know, here on YouTube. And they'll do all these videos, you know, stand-up comedy on acid, monster truck rally on acid. CIA, brethren. Okay, that's what this thing is. Again, you know, break down this little illusion of the government's a good thing. You know, I mean, there might be decent people within the government, but for the most part, it's extremely corrupt, controlled by the Vatican. Bad news. And again, we'll talk about how to fight them towards the end of the video here. But let's continue here. It says, it's police, sheriff, and courts are extremely corrupt. Yes. And kidnap children from good Christian homes on a regular basis. Nearby is Los Angeles County, which actually put the FBI Man Boy Love logo on their hexagram badges, see below, and it is not a coincidence that every cop wears a hexagram on themselves. Hexagram, okay, six-pointed star, like the Star of David, you think of that. It's an occult symbol, okay? I support the nation of Israel insofar as I believe that they have, God's brought them back in unbelief to their land, for his sake, not for their sake, but for his sake, to fulfill Bible prophecy. The Jews have a right to be over there in Israel. But their country, their government is completely bought and paid for by the Vatican, right? They're working right now with, the Jerusalem became an international city years ago, and it's basically the Pope has the rights to rule and reign from there, which is going to be the Antichrist in the future. I mean, that's, again, another huge subject. But let me put these pictures up here. You can see there the badge, the Los Angeles County Sheriff or Deputy Sheriff there badge, and you can see this little symbol there, this triangle within a triangle. And I'll show you here the unclassified law enforcement sensitive Federal Bureau of Investigation Intelligence Bulletin, Cyber Division, Innocent Images, National Initiative, 31st of January 2007. Symbols and logos used by pedophiles to identify sexual preferences. This intelligence bulletin addresses crimes against children standing intelligence requirements set contained in the numbers there. Pedophiles to include those who sexually abuse children as well as those who produce, distribute, and trade child pornography are using various types of identification logos or symbols to recognize one another and distinguish their sexual preferences. To specifically indicate the pedophile's gender preference, members of pedophile organizations encourage the use of descriptions such as boy love or girl love and child love. These symbols have been etched into rings and formed into pendants and have also been found imprinted on coins. The boy lover logo is a small blue spiral-shaped triangle surrounded by a larger triangle, whereby the small triangle represents a small boy, and the larger triangle represents an adult man. A variation of the BL logo is the little boy lover logo, which also embodies a small spiral-shaped triangle within a larger triangle. However, the corners of the LBL logo are rounded to resemble a scribbling by a young child. Images of the BL or the B logo and LBL or LB logo symbols are depicted below. There you can see the pictures of it there. Okay, now I need to say something here. All right, right now, this sick, disgusting country is redefining, you know, the terms of sexual perversion. There's a lot of people that don't believe in sexual perversion anymore, just alternate lifestyles. And right now, there's still that thing there of child pornography is wrong. You can still get in trouble for it. But you mark my words, they're going to say in the future, it's not that bad. See? They're pushing the envelope all the time, further out and further out and further out. Why? Because the people that are pushing it are themselves sexual perverts. Hollywood is pushing this thing. Hollywood is rife with pedophilia. I'll tell you that right now. And when you have the police putting the symbol on their badges, okay, you're not going to get any kind of justice from the laws of this land, right? If you say, well, we'll work through the court system and think, that those times are gone, brethren. And I'm going to give you the solutions here in a little bit about what we can do as Christians. But let's continue here. It says here, San Bernardino also had an Air Force base, which is now closed, called Norton Air Force Base, which was turned into a private international airport about 1990. Okay, they do this thing all over the country. Again, down in Mena, Arkansas, they were doing this thing with an airport down there. I don't remember if it was an Air Force Base, but I know it was an airport, and they were bringing flying drugs in, the drug running operations under Bill Clinton when he was governor down there back in the 1980s and 90s, right in that area there. And there was like a couple young teenagers that saw this drug running stuff, and the police just killed them. I mean, they took him out, and basically, I don't know if I think they beat him up first, and then they threw him on train tracks, and the trains ran over him. Okay, I mean, sick stuff. I mean, the MENA, Arkansas drug operation thing, again, if you don't understand, the CIA, Catholics in Action, like Eric Phelps calls them, and that's aptly named. But what they do is they'll send guns and things and weapons down to the Sandinistas in Nicaragua, which is what they were doing there, in exchange for them producing drugs, which they can bring back up through, airports and things like this, abandoned Air Force bases, bringing in the drugs, and then they have people that they distributed out into the cities. I mean, like I heard a black guy say the one time, he said, "How are black guys, black drug dealers in Philadelphia growing cocaine to sell on the streets? How are they getting cocaine?" Think about that, okay? They're getting it from the CIA that's bringing it in through these airports and things. The Vietnam War was all about this. Again, there was a whole big case there where back during the Vietnam War, these dead bodies of soldiers, they were literally gutting them, pulling their intestines out and everything else, and stuffing the body cavities with drugs. Then they'd sew them back up. They'd bring them into an Army medical base in Virginia, and there was a doctor there, Jeffrey McDonald. And Jeffrey McDonald became aware of what was going on, and he said, "I'm going to tell people about it." They sent us in a satanic network. Helena Stokely was one of the ones involved, and they stabbed his wife and his little girls to death. And it was part of her initiation, Helena Stokely's initiation. She came out later and told about it, and she got killed herself. But McDonald is still in prison to this day because all he was going to do is just tell people about it. See, but again, he's going to go through the law system. But they control the law system. See, that's why you need a different solution to fight these monsters. But we actually have a abandoned Air Force base up here in northern Maine, Loring Air Force Base. We've been there a couple times. I've showed some videos. They were like had huge stockpiles of military vehicles up there in the one area. We went up, filmed the thing, and a short time after that, went up there, all the vehicles are gone. I mean, we're here, we live right not too far from the highway, and we're seeing military vehicles going south, and just weird stuff goes on in this country, believe you me. But anyhow, let's continue here. I had done a little research and found that in Palm Springs, California, which is about 30 minutes from San Bernardino, there was a pedophile scandal which involved homosexual Catholic priests, or properly called sodomites. Yeah, that's the Bible word. The Catholic priest Paul R. Shanley was a priest in Newtown or Newton, Massachusetts. He was caught molesting children there, and the highest-ranking members of the Catholic Church moved him to San Bernardino County when his crimes became public. Yeah, he was working with Bishop Law, or Bernard Law, excuse me, Bishop, Bernard Law. He was another child molester, and under Benedict, Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger, then he became Pope Benedict XVI. He was moving these guys all around and stuff like this, because see, child molestation is part of Roman Catholicism. It's an integral part of the Roman Catholic system because at the top, Roman Catholics are Luciferians, and they understand that by defiling, by raping children, that child has their mind warped and it twists the child against Jesus Christ. Let me show you this because I did show this in my satanic ritual abuse thing, my video on that. But let me just show you what I'm talking about here. Okay. Now this is the First Communion Catechism. Okay. Now look at this down here. The priest takes Christ's place. Say you're sitting in the confessional and the priest says to be absolved of your sins, you have to make a good confession and you have to tell me all the things that you've done, including lust and whatever else. Have you ever masturbated? Have you ever looked at a woman or whatever, and the child a lot of times is going, "What are you talking about?" They defile the child, and then if they can rape the child, that's even better because now the child says, "That wasn't the priest." If they understand Catholic doctrine, they say, "That wasn't the priest that raped me, that was Jesus Christ that raped me." So that child grows up to be a God-hating atheist. Why do you think that there's so many stories of atheists coming out and saying, I was raised in church, but I hate God now? And it happens in Protestant churches too, I might add. I personally knew of a guy that was raped by a Methodist at a Methodist camp for children. Ended up killing himself later on. But anyways, let's continue here. Let's see here. Shanley lived in Palm Springs from about 1990, the year my... Okay, I won't say that. One of her children was born. And was living with his sodomite lover, another Catholic priest from Massachusetts named Father John J. White. Together they opened and ran a sodomite hotel called Cabana Club Resort in Palm Springs, California, and White was the sole owner of another sodomite hotel there called Whispering Palms. And you can look this stuff up. I mean, this is documented. The article stated that they were abducting boys from the San Bernardino area to be molested by rich pedophiles that were being flown in from around the world and stayed in their pedophile sodomite hotels. Okay, let me just say something there, too. It's kind of an interesting little side note. Fukushima, when the wave hit over there in Japan, that whole Fukushima area, and took out the nuclear plant and everything. I remember I was talking to an older brother at that point, and he said, did you know what was, you know, in that area there, the people that lived in that area? He said there was a lot of rich Japanese businessmen that were flying to the Philippines to have sex with little boys. They were pedophiles living in that area. See, our God is in control, brethren. A lot of times you look and you see these horrible natural disasters coming in just wiping out an area and you go, wow, what a shame. You're saying what a shame because you're listening to the news media. Let me tell you something. God's not going to send something like a tsunami like that to hit innocent people. He sends that stuff on the lost, on the reprobates. You know, I remember this thing, there was a bad earthquake back years ago in the Dominican Republic, Haiti. And I remember I had a brother, and he was like, man, isn't that terrible? What happened in Haiti? I said, do you realize, brother, that they actually, the president of Haiti, dedicated his whole country to Satan a number of years ago? Again, look it up. Look it up. I'm not making this stuff up. Actually dedicated his country to Satan. And then it gets hit by a massive earthquake, and a whole bunch of people die. And they're having all these problems down there. But we should send them aid and things. No, you shouldn't. No, you shouldn't. Send them missionaries. But don't you dare send these people aid and things. But anyways, it says here, I also read that there are at least 40 sodomite hotels in the Palm Springs area, which are clothing, optional bed and breakfast for round-the-clock pedophilia, I'm sure. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. A lot of the rich are, you know, I remember hearing a guy say the one time, success in this world is a lot like a pond. The scum rises to the top. Very well said. The love of money is the root of all evil. So then what can you deduce by that? If the love of money is the root of all evil, and that which is highly esteemed among men is an abomination in the sight of God, the friend of the world is the enemy of God, the Bible says, then who are the people at the very top, success-wise? They're the worst people. Absolutely. So are the rich people involved in all kinds of satanic ritual abuse and pedophilia and all kinds of rape and just terrible stuff? Yeah. Yeah. And some of it is for the purposes of programming. You know, again, you know, I see these Christians, you know, we should, you know, I see people and they're trying to like emulate Hollywood actors and stuff like this. Hollywood actors are some of the lowest lowlifes out there. And I'm, you know, pray for them. I know some that have actually gotten saved. I've had contact with some of them that have gotten saved and they get out of the system. But I mean, you got to do some pretty sick stuff to get into that, the highest levels of Hollywood. You know, they're just high paid, you know, prostitutes, male and female. You know, and I care about them. I'd like to see them get saved and stuff. But for goodness sake, you got to get out of that system. But let's continue here. Next paragraph, it says, Shanley was immersed in the sodomite pedophile scene soon after his arrival in 1990, and he was given a position leading youth retreats at St. Anne's in the city of San Bernardino. As evidence of his sexual abuses gathered against him, the police ignored the reports, and they had no regard for whether they had continued contact with children because the police were helping them run the pedophile ring. Absolutely. It happens a lot. It is not a coincidence that the San Bernardino Sheriff's Department got their hands slapped for creating a ride-along program for children, where it was made public that many of the cops with hexagram badges, with their pervert badges, were molesting the children when they got them in their cars for the ride-along. The program was claimed to have been discontinued, and none of the cops were prosecuted for their crimes against children. I have a long list of cop names from both the San Bernardino Sheriff's Department and San Bernardino Police Department who were all put on paid leave after they were caught molesting children. Yeah, they do that too. They'll put them on paid leave. The cops in San Bernardino have a long history of pedophilia and other sex crimes which have been made public throughout the years. And as for the Catholic priest named Shanley, he was made to stand trial in Newton, Massachusetts for his crimes against children and was given an 18-year sentence as of November 2015. He is inmate W84979 at the Old Colony Correctional Center in Massachusetts, and the local cops now claim that his pedophile priest boyfriend, White, committed suicide and cannot be convicted for any of his crimes against children. How convenient. Yeah, exactly. The Catholic Church will do that too. Don't doubt that. They'll kill off certain priests, you know, kill them. There are some stories about this Tony Palmer guy. He wasn't even a Catholic priest. He was, I think, Church of England. But the whole point is he was coming out and pushing the Pope's agenda. He's the guy that was speaking at the conference there with all the Pentecostal pastors with Kenneth Copeland. Saying that the Reformation's over and everything. I put out a video on him, and he supposedly died in a motorcycle accident. But people were calling the hospital, and they were like, you know, is Tony Palmer, what happened there? Oh, he left. He walked out yesterday, signed out, and everything else. Well, he didn't die? I had heard that he died. No, he didn't die, you know, secretaries were saying. So, weird stuff. But let's continue here. It was stated that these two sodomites were of the most serious pedophile priests ever discovered. Shanley is known for his writings. One is called Changing Norms of Sexuality, and he attended a sodomite conference where he was a part of the founding of NAMBLA, the North American Man-Boy Love Association, is what that stands for. Actually, it says it there. For sodomites who lust to openly rape little boys. It is also not a coincidence that the NAMBLA symbol of raping little boys is on the LA Sheriff's Department hexagram badges. Okay, and again, what is the hexagram? The hexagram, the six-pointed star. Where else do we see that? A veiled reference of it. Well, you have the square and compass of masonry. Put the two together. Okay? The upward-pointing trial is the male. The downward-pointing trial is the female. You put them together, what do you have? Intercourse. It's a sex symbol. And G in the middle there, in the Masonic G, means generativity. Say, no, it means gnosis or geometry or God or something like this. They'll have multiple explanations that they can give to the public, and the public goes, oh, that's not too bad after all. It's God, you know. Yeah, no, it's generativity. From my research, that's what it means. Talking about the male organ, okay? Again, you go back to the Bible. What's the Bible talk about? The priests of Baal. The priests of Baal were worshiping sexuality. They were perverts. That's why they get into the whole rising of the sun thing. There's a lot of occult symbology there and everything else. It's, you know, not much changes, brethren. Okay? You read the Bible sometimes and you go, wow, it just seems so distant, so far away. Well, keep reading and keep studying what goes on in the world and you'll realize, no, actually things haven't really changed that much. The Bible is very up-to-date. King James Bible. But continuing here. It is also not a coincidence that the Shanley trial was very controversial because it involved repressed memories from mind control techniques used on them. I personally know that the ELF technology that was used by Addy in Redlands, California is a technique that requires the victim's memories be erased and new false memories are then given to the victim. Recalling those erased or repressed memories is very difficult for many, and they also use harmonic sound from ELF radio waves to continue controlling the victim. Okay, now this is an area that I have not done a whole lot of research into it. I've heard of this thing of harmonics. I think it's very interesting. I do know that the CIA, there was some kind of a women's protest. I think it was in Ireland or the UK. I forget where. But and I shouldn't say CIA. It might have been what's the was it MI5? I think the British intelligence, but whoever, they used radio frequency to basically make these women that were protesting make them feel nauseous and confused and, you know, disoriented and things. Yeah, that stuff is there, and it's some scary stuff. Let me tell you what. Some of this electrical frequency stuff and things like that, I mean, it's mess up your head. You know, it's pretty bad. And I mean, I think the full fulfillment of this is going to be in the time of Jacob's trouble, where you have these people that take the mark. They're actually taking, you know, the Bible says that the mark is going to be in the right hand or in the forehead. And they're talking about brain chip implants and stuff. I think we're literally getting to the point where these people are not going to be able to understand biblical salvation that take this mark. That's why you see that, you know, if any man takes a mark, he gets God's wrath. Because I think that they're not going to even be capable anymore after taking the mark, both spiritual and even technologically speaking. I think it's going to just totally change the brain pattern. And then you throw in all the pharmaceuticals and the food additives and everything else. I mean, it's just like a nightmare cocktail of mind control that's in the world right now. But this thing of repressed memories, you know, there's a lot of stuff. Again, they'll go after small children because small children, you forget things. You know, I mean, my own son, he's 2.5 years old. You know, he gets in trouble and, you know, yell at him and stuff, and he'll cry and everything else. And 5 minutes later, he's back to being little goofy boy running around laughing and having a good time. Children forget things, you know, and, you know, discipline is an important thing there for a child. But, you know, it's just like people can take this stuff and they can pervert it and twist it, and they can do horrible things to children, and the children end up forgetting this stuff. And again, another good reason why you don't want to let your children go off to public school or outside of your care. It's very, very important to homeschool your children. But I'm getting ahead of myself. You know, let's continue here. And by the way, you know, I've had it accused, you know, I've been accused of abusing my son or something by people. It's like, first of all, people aren't even here. They don't even know this stuff. They're just trying to say stuff to put us down. I heard recently there's someone, I don't know if I mentioned this in another study, but I'll just say it again because it's so absurd. Some woman is calling, you know, the authorities and stuff in our area trying to say I abuse children. It's like, you don't even know me, you know? What in the world? We don't abuse our child. Abuse our son. Good night. But they'll come up with anything. They're desperate. But let's continue here. Says here, I too have been subjected to this. She's been subjected to a lot of this stuff here, elf radio waves and things. But the Lord has restored most of my memory that has been erased. I am fortunate because I had such an excellent childhood with great parents that it was too difficult to convince me of the opposite, which is required for mind control. I am also surrounded by those who enjoy talking about all the things the neighborhood children did in childhood, so they helped me remember real events and not false ones. That is another reason why it is so important to the pedophile sodomites to remove the children from their parents, who will nurture them and help them to retain good memories. I can remember from my own childhood, there was a kindergarten teacher. She was a drunk. Mrs. McGovern, her name was. Paradise Elementary School. And when it would come time for your birthday, she would spank you for the one time for each of the years. And I remember thinking at the time, I thought, this is really stupid. What is this about? In front of all the other children, you gotta be spanked. You know, they didn't pull your pants down or anything, but it was just like, what is this? You know, and it, weird stuff, you know, like that. I don't think that there was ever any kind of weird abuse, mind control stuff. I don't remember anything like that. But public schools are just, I mean, we're talking like back in the early 1980s when I was going to public school. So, you know, Lancaster County is a fairly conservative place and all that stuff, but, you know, unlike California, is obviously going to be a lot worse, but there's still, you know, some weird stuff that goes on in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania. But on to the next paragraph. It is not a coincidence that the Shanley victims were also mind control victims. that were able to recover the repressed memories that they had lost. Since this case, several courts have flaunted that they are so corrupt that they will not allow recovered memories to be discussed, claiming that it is too controversial. There is also a tie to the McMartin preschool pedophile ring that went to trial in 1990 in L.A., California, with Raymond Buckey and the San Bernardino pedophile ring, which involved the local cops with their hexagram badges. I was told that the San Bernardino has a network of underground tunnels under the city, which lead to a satanic castle, which is located in Crestline, California, and is known for satanic rituals. Okay, I do have files on this. Again, there was a whole thing where this McMartin, can't get into a whole lot of this, but here's some of my files on it. Okay, if you can see that. And it gets into some of the stuff on it where they were actually, I'll just show some of the stuff here. November 22nd, June 1st, 1992. The spotlight. These are photo scanned things here. You can see it there. And it was all covered up. The trial lasted for a few years. I think it was like a total cost of like $15 million. Absolutely ridiculous. The guilty people got away with it. Here's another one of the guys. Obituary. Louis Julian Jolly West. This guy was involved in the mind control programming. Right there. Can't really zoom in too good on the actual documents. But he was involved in a lot of the thing. He continued his studies of brainwashing over the years, along with his work in post-traumatic stress syndrome, alcohol and drug abuse, pain, sleep problems, dreams, and hypnosis. He studied torture and brainwashing during the Korean War when he was an Air Force doctor at Lackland Air Force Base in Texas. Yeah, military is just involved in this stuff. It's just incredible. Here we have, this is the LA Times. April the 4th of 1999, CIA's Gottlieb ran LSD mind control testing. Scientist who died at 80 oversaw invention of devices for assassination and gave acid to human guinea pigs. There, right there. There he is. The article. And, this stuff is real. That's all I can say. It's there. See if there's anything else I want to show here. Basically, the McMartin preschool thing was there was a school by a woman named McMartin, Peggy McMartin, and her son Raymond Buckey. And this is photo scan images. They're not real great, but you can see right there. There she is, McMartin. This is one of the plates that was found down underneath the school. In some of the tunnels. These tunnels basically were filled in, and they claimed they were just putting trash down in there and stuff, because the children were reporting being in the preschool and being taken down through tunnels over to abandoned buildings to be molested and satanic ritual stuff being done to them and everything else. Absolutely horrible and disgusting. And after years and years and years of trial, $15 million spent, not one person was convicted. Okay? That's why I'm saying you go through the law, you go through the court system and whatever else, they get control of all that stuff. Through the Masons, through the Knights of Columbus, through a lot of these other organizations. So, but let's continue here. As for the latest San Bernardino shooting at North Park Elementary School, it is a part of this, and none of their claims make any sense. The claim is that they were married a few months ago, this black couple, already separated, and the shooter chose to shoot his wife at an elementary school when it is much more convenient to do it when she got home. Yeah, makes sense. Most people who kill spouses are too self-centered to kill themselves. And it is also not a coincidence that his wife supposedly worked with retarded children. I'll say more on that in just a little bit. And the original San Bernardino shooting 2 years ago was also the county EMPS who supposedly worked with retarded children. Please note that San Bernardino is a charter city where the mayor controls the police, fire, and school district. Okay. Maybe together we can discover what the Lord is directing me to do with all of this. I'm not going to read some of this personal stuff here because I want to protect her and everything. Please, he's talking about her children are unfortunately messed up with this, some of this stuff here. That's some of the things that are going on. Please pray for me also, and thank you for taking the time to listen. You are the first two people that I have known to be awake enough to tell this to, and it's such a blessing that you are lovers of the Lord also. Please let me know your thoughts on this, and that you are at least listening. It is so very appreciated. Yeah, definitely listening. This stuff gets me very, very angry. I have a great hatred for child molesters. No love at all for them. I think that they should all be executed publicly, to be quite frank. But we're going to talk about solutions now from the Bible. Okay, I have said a little bit about what I know about this child molestation stuff that goes on here in America. It is always going to be tied back to Roman Catholicism. Somehow, Masonry is controlled by the Jesuits, the Knights of Columbus, the Knights of Malta, all these different organizations. Again, one of the initiations that they'll do into this system is to get into this thing, you have to do some sick stuff. That way they have dirt on you in case you ever decide to go forward and go public. They'll frame up politicians and things. There was a guy, Craig Spence, see me if I can find this book here. Craig Spence, who was involved in basically setting up politicians here in America with prostitutes and, little children and stuff like this as a way to blackmail politicians. He'd get the politician drunk, film them, doing horrible things with little children or prostitutes, and then use that as, blackmail, basically, to get them to vote for certain things and agendas. Right there is his picture, if I can get that. Hopefully you can see that. This guy over here, Larry King, not the television show guy, but this guy here, Larry King, was very much involved with the Republican Party in Nebraska, and he was, molesting a lot of these children and setting them up for these different parties and things. Here you have this Washington Times in June 29th, 1989. Homosexual prostitution inquiry ensnares VIPs with Reagan and Bush. Children taken there late at night. I think I'm getting that. Okay. Show you another thing here. This is out in Nebraska. They spell Nebraska backwards, Xarban. These guys are some sick tickets dressed up as, and this is a 1967 book on Xarban. Displays this picture of a 1923 Xarban festivity showing male Xarban members dressed as Egyptian dancing girls. 1923, Nebraska. The heartland, farming country. Yeah, Masonic perverts is what they are. Right there you go. Okay. Do you wonder why all this transvestite stuff is going on and everything else? There's a spiritual connection to it. And again, if you're a sodomite or a lot of these people, these children that are molested, they'll grow up to be sodomites because they're really confused, a man raping a little boy and things or whatever else. It really messes with the head. So it's quite disgusting. I mean, if you're part of this sodomite or transgender movement, you've gone through some mind control. A lot of them have been raped. Firmly believe that. But all this to say, our King James Bible talks about this. The whole world, lies in wickedness. The Bible talks about, It's something that, most people don't want to talk about because it's uncomfortable and whatever else. And, again, I've talked about this in other videos, but these church buildings are ancient Greek phallic temples. They're, you look at the old Greek Parthenons, they got the columns out front, they got the slanted roof like that, the peaked roof with the columns. You look at church buildings, that's the architecture. And they put a obelisk on top, they call it a steeple and things. But I mean, again, I showed the proof of that from, architecture publications and things where they're saying it's a phallic symbol. It's the symbol of the male organ. And so you get these preachers inside these buildings and you say, why aren't they talking about this pedophilia stuff? Why aren't they talking about this? Why you go to them and they treat you like you're nuts? Well, because there's a spiritual curse on those buildings. I'll tell you that right now. That's why there are so many people that there's sex problems in these church buildings. Because you're in a temple that in ancient times was used for sexual purposes. You can't Christianize that. You can't make that thing right. And of course, the other reason is because most preachers are worried about their income and their, image and whatever else. And it's just quite disgusting. And a lot of them, they have no idea what to do about this whole thing. But we're going to look at solutions now. Okay? The problem is real. If you're out there and you've been a victim of this, you're not crazy. But you have to be careful who you go to for help. Okay? And I'm going to show you today what kind of things that you can do to make problems for these Satanists, be they Jesuits or Masons or some of these wicked police and stuff that are involved in this thing. But let's continue here.